Hey, furry.
Just the guy I was looking for. Provided I can hit you with this magical dust.
Thankfully, this bag is only limited by the amount of magic I have, and not the amount of powder within it.
That's always a good
thing. Too bad they change it in a sequel.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to be around to be alive to... Oh, my goodness. This is the... Unless four Death Star, the three Link.
And there's the cane. We just saved ourselves a great deal.
But then again, back then, I thought 1, 2, 3, and 4 Link were all the same person.
Back before anyone could tell you about a little thing called...
Timelines!
I never really paid attention to that detail. Because I didn't really care. It's just... Meh. Zelda thing. Similar to how I rarely paid attention to the Mario one, too, because, Well, that happened. I think you can pull those statues.
I tried one. There we go. There, you can escape.
No, I mean those two armored statues.
Oh, yeah, possibly.
Because I think the boss might be down there.
Tonk, tonk. Nailed it.
Yep, have fun.
Hammer.
Burn him.
Burn him. Alright. You want to see a big block of something, I'm thinking. Hammer, but we've already...
And you have blue potions, too, so that works, too.
Yeah. Is he also weak against fire?
You can hit him with fire if you wish, yeah. Or hit him with your sword, one or the other.
Being weak to something. Ha! Hit him with both.
Shouldn't have used all your magic powder.
And you have fairies too, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you got this.
Start?
What are you trying to do?
Open the start menu so I can drink a blue potion.
You want to burninate? He wants to burninate.
Right, I have to move horizontally off the bottles.
Nailed it!
Woo!
One more function to go.
Technically two, but who's counting?
Well, one more function.
To the function!
The fudge dungeon. Next is the fudge dungeon.
Sucking on a dick.
Or Heath, because of you I can escape from the clutches of the evil monsters.
Mysterious powers.
The blood of the Helia has become thin over time.
Yeah, wait, too much.
Helians are a dying breed?
Apparently.
In this version, anyway.
In this history.
Well, then again, in the history, it was saying, like, after, like, there was two different alternating timelines.
Yeah,
three. With Zelda Ocarina of Time, this would take place if... Link lost.
Okay.
So the Helians would technically be dying out because of the...
Dark World's corruption killing everyone.
Yeah.
Leaking into the Light World.
If the Seven Maidens are supposed to be based off of the Seven Sages from Ocarina...
Well, that...
Then that means that all of those non-Helian sages have bred with Helians to produce Helian children somewhere in their family line.
And that the sages didn't die at the end of Ocarina, killing some fan theories. Well,
yeah, because they were safely hidden away in the...
Sacred Realm.
Yeah, in the Sacred Realm. Yeah. In the Temple of Light, where Rama can keep them safe.
Apparently they have a, some sort of biosphere in there.
Where Link gets to be sad because he doesn't get to hit that Saria ass.
He's too busy being
Saria dead. Doesn't grow up!
I know.
So, there's no point.
Well...
Maybe if they'd actually grown up together.
To say that there's no... They did grow up together.
But... I guess.
For the brief amount of time that Link was a child living in the Kokiri Forest.
They were young together. Link grew up all of a sudden and had earrings placed on him without his permission.
Nobody recognized who he was, though they thought he seemed awful familiar.
Mm-hmm. And then there was the whole, who was it? I remember there was, some interview, either with, Eiji Aonuma or, Miyamoto, whichever had, I guess, more creative control over the series. Like, who was it that put the earrings on Link? And they were like, It would have to have been Ryuru. Ryuru, who decided that Link would be great, good-looking with earrings or whatever.
He also accepted the fact that he was going to be needing bigger clothes.
Yeah. Well, I guess, like, making clothes or whatever when you have 7 years of waiting around.
And the fact that he made the clothes, he took the clothes off of a child and gave him adult clothes.
I guess. I guess he wouldn't have waited for the clothes to suffocate him.
Point made.
Yeah. So at some point there would have been a necessity for that.
I'm afraid nudity does not, in fact, make you a better hero. It makes you kind of a pervert.
It also would have made for an extra scene to animate if Link had shown up in the, drawn the sword for the first time, then suddenly as an adult and all his clothes are ill-fitting or torn or whatever.
They did. No child's media will ever accept the
they
fact...
They sort of did that with Kingdom Hearts.
No child's media will ever accept the fact that when you drink a potion or something that makes you bigger, your clothes didn't drink the potion, too.
Yeah, unless they spilled it on themselves.
The only time in anything that could be comparable to a child's media that I saw did that was Archie's Weird Mystery. Where Veronica drinks this thing or gets zapped by a laser that makes her huge, but her clothes don't grow with her.
Oh, joy. Oh, joy.
Every other time I've seen it in any other medium, it's always been, no, the clothes are apparently biologically fit to you. That's why you only wear one thing.
Actually, that reminds me of the 20-something Alice in Wonderland by Tim Burton.
Yeah.
When Alice shrinks, her clothes stay the same size, but she climbs out of her dress, and she's wearing another dress.
It's a good thing I kept my Barbie doll in my pocket.
Ow.
Wait, did Barbie exist yet? She had to have. Maybe.
Pretty sure. 20-something?
In Alice's world.
I guess it would have been, 18-something.
Yeah, but... What country is the
Barbie doll?
The story of... The story of Alice in Wonderland.
European nation. All I remember was that the overarching troubles were about some kind of trading company or some kind of business.
What was your plan?
Oh no, wait, they were trying to set her up for marriage and she wanted to break apart and just do her own thing, like open up a business.
She fell asleep one day and got with a rabbit running away.
Nah. So well, have you seen the 20-something else?
I haven't seen the live-action, and I'm not familiar with the original story either.
Oh!
My only understanding of it is the Disney variant.
Okay. I would actually recommend watching the 1983 or 1985 live-action Alice in Wonderland, because it's something like 3 hours long. They split it into two parts for TV, and it's, they cover just about every possible scene from the book and its sequel.
Oh yeah, I was thinking of Wizard of Oz for a second there, because there was an anime adaptation of that as well.
And they called in, No, I'm not talking about an anime adaptation. I'm talking about a live-action movie. 3-hour movie. And it's huge. They cover every possible scenario. And, they even turn up... They even, I don't want to say turn it into a musical, because... even though it was a book, there were a lot of songs portrayed in the book. Songs and poems in the book anyway. So I guess they portrayed it as the musical it was meant to be. It's really well done. That's the best rendition of Alice in Wonderland that I've ever seen. And then the 20-something, Tim Burton one is sort of a sequel.
It wasn't that bad either.
It was nice.
I didn't mind.
I mean, if you don't mind someone taking their own creative liberties with the source material, then it's good. It's a Tim Burton film more than an Alice film.
Well, the nostalgic critic went and bashed the living shit out of that movie just the other
person. Yeah, I think I saw his rendition of it. I think it was just... That was just the nostalgic critic doing what the nostalgic critic does.
Yeah.
You know? That was a nostalgic critic episode more than an actual criticizing the movie episode.
I Are you lost?
No, I'm trying to remember which hole I have to jump down to find the cane of... What's it called?
Burna.
Yeah.
You call it the cane of Burna, but it doesn't really burn things. I've already got a cane of Burna right here. I've also got a cane of Frieza.
Okay, I'll be in the dark hole, I guess. Can we stop for a minute?
No. No!
Okay, let's jump down there one more time for good measure.
Okay.
You now have the power of color. The color is blue.
What does that do?
They give you two powers of color in the sequel. But
I like that.
Version two.
I like that. That was cool.
The power of color?
Yeah.
I think it was dumb that they called it the power of color because it was on the Game Boy Color.
I liked it because you can choose either defense or
attack. But it's basically just a permanent piece of power or permanent acorn of defense. And then that rendered the appropriate item useless because it wouldn't stack.
Fuck.
Oh!
Nice sit down, Jordan.
Oh! Bollocks.
Oh.
Good thing they give you a bunch of these.
And not the thing you need to get out.
Cane of Burna.
A ring of light will protect you.
With no magic to protect you with. Aww.
Yeah, you're right. Fuck it.
Just run out.
Yeah.
Walk out, rather.
The fairy will save you.
It's just a weird incidental that they're recorded for this. If it is even recorded.
What the hell is the matter with you?
I like the beepings.
I like the way it makes them sound.
I'm not a sick person. No.
This scene here, I think they showed it in like Nintendo Power previews. And I'm like, this looks like a really neat environment. You don't see it till the end of the game.
Yeah. I had a Nintendo Power that covered a lot of Link to the Past.
What I don't like about most of the Zelda games is that a lot of them are very guide heavy. In that, if you want to know most,
yeah, Zelda 1 for sure.
Yeah.
Zelda 2.
I could never get into
Zelda
1.
Zelda 2
you can
didn't
kind
seem...
of brain your way through it.
Yeah.
But it's almost as bad as point-and-click games, where you have to use every object on every other object. Zelda 3 is, like, I guess the first game you can really just play through with nothing but the game.
I can understand it in the era that it's from, because it's like, well, this is the only game you have, you're going to be playing it a lot.
Yeah. You're going to sink, like, if all you do is school, and then home, and then, like, wait till your parents tell you to go to sleep... Then yeah, you're going to sink a lot of hours into this, and you're going to figure out a lot of the difficult puzzles on your own.
Which is why I kind of wish I owned Metroid when I was a little kid, because then I would have spent a lot of time playing Metroid, but now I don't have the patience for it, because I own so much. If I'm not having fun, it's like, well, I could turn this off and do something better.
Yeah. Eat a fairy?
Get in my mouth, fairy woman.
Yeah, we're good.
Eat a fairy? I always thought it was weird the way that they just... People just kind of accepted that you eat these things.
Shit.
Nothing else could possibly have been done. Like, it's not like they're casting healing magic on you or anything. You're eating them.
Well, except when you die, though.
Yeah, then they sprinkle their dust on you or whatever.
That's what happens.
Oh, poor little boy.
That's what happens
died.
When Link gets hit with magic dust.
That's a magic dust, little boy!
Sure, that reminds me of that, the Disney scene where, the Peter Pan scene. Where he's like, he grabs Tinkerbell out of the air and like shakes her above someone. That's kind of mean, isn't it?
No, I hear fairies like it like that.
What, they like being handled rough?
Violently against their will?
One, for sure. The other one, not so much.
Fuck.
There's one in particular that loves being handled rough.
Oh, really?
You know the one.
Stella?
Stella? No, I don't know if she likes being handled rough.
She likes to talk like she does.
Flapping hell.
Ah, bloody flapping. Gonna buy up some property.
Yeah,
not phallic. You can't do that.
It's not... Yeah, like... Those... Like, the walls that you can charge into are almost broken.
There, I did it! Fuck!
Congrats.
You can buy your bombs back!
Oh my god! I haven't seen the light of day in so long! Watch something, will you?
There.
I use these bombs, but they're merchandise!
Hands off the merchandise.
You are flat broke.
Yep, because I had to buy that one hard...
You got your lucky penny.
Gotta have that lucky dime.
It's not your lucky dime, it's your lucky penny.
Up there.
Hookshot?
Yep. There.
Boom! Fuck!
I think I might be lost.
You have found fairy heaven.
Well...
There must be one hole I haven't gone into.
See if you can't recalibrate yourself by the time we come back.
Okay, fine. We'll come back next time.